The table shows two systems of linear equations. Indicate whether each system of equations has no solution, one solution, or infinitely many solutions by selecting the correct cell in the table. So it'll be very easy to see the number of solutions a system has if both equations in the system are written in slope-intercept form. So let's look at the first column system where we have y equals negative x and 8y equals negative 8x. So if we look at those two equations, the first equation, y equals negative x, is written in slope-intercept form. The y is by itself. So the slope is the coefficient of x, which is negative 1. And there is no constant, so that means our b is 0. The y-intercept is 0. Now, the second equation is not written in slope-intercept form, 8y equals negative 8x, because the y is not by itself. We need to get the y by itself by dividing both sides by 8, which gives us y equals negative x. Now that that's written in slope-intercept form, we can see the slope is negative 1, the coefficient of x, and there's no constant, so that means b equals 0. The y-intercept is 0. Now comparing the two equations in slope-intercept form, we can see they have the same slope, both negative 1, the same y-intercept, both b equals 0. In fact, these are the same exact line. Written in slope-intercept form, they're both y equals negative x. So since these two equations are representing the same line, they're intersecting in infinitely many points, so there's going to be infinitely many solutions to that system. Now we're going to do the same exact thing to the second system. Right, we found that the first system has infinitely many solutions because when written in slope-intercept form, those are the same equation for the same line. Now let's look at the second system. So we have y equals, now it's in parentheses 3x plus 1, but there's nothing to distribute except for a coefficient maybe of 1. So our equation is 3x plus 1. And that's in slope-intercept form. We can see our slope is 3, the coefficient of x. And our y-intercept is 1, that constant. The second equation, y equals negative 4, is in slope-intercept form as well. You just don't have an x variable, meaning our slope is 0, and the constant is negative 4, so that's our y-intercept. So comparing these two equations, we can automatically see they have different slopes. One has a slope of 3, and one has a slope of 0. So that means it doesn't even matter what their y-intercepts are. If they have different slopes, they're different lines that will intersect in one point. So there's going to be exactly one solution to that system. So the first system has infinitely many solutions. The second system has one solution. So our choices are 3 and 5, making our answer choice B.